This is an original French Grande poster from 1984, advertising Fritz Lang's 1927 film, Metropolis. The poster had heavy creasing. We flattened it out on a linen backing at Poster Fix. Hi, I'm Chris. Welcome to Poster Fix Studio. Today, a French Grande from the movie Metropolis. It's quite large, 47 by 63 inches. When we got this poster, it was folded. And as I unfolded it, I could see that the fold creases were very heavy.
Well, this is in beautiful condition, but it's got these heavy creases in it, folio folds. And the back is clean, but I'm also seeing that there's a rip here in the fold and a rip there in the fold. So some intersection rips, but the back is clean of tape or any other residue.
So we're gonna put this poster on a linen backing to flatten it out. I've already prepared a stretcher screen. This is stretched cotton canvas mounted with acid-free paper, which I just did a few moments ago, so it's still wet. And now I'm going to lay the poster down onto the acid-free paper. I have to get a sense of its position on the screen. To flatten out these creases, I'm going to have to linen back it. The Metropolis named in this film is a fictional city, a city of the future, a city full of Art Deco buildings. I used to think that all the buildings in this film looked like versions of the Empire State Building or the Chrysler Building, except on steroids. The movie has a beautiful, gigantic model of the futuristic city with overpasses and helicopters and little flying machines and cars and all sorts of things. It's really an amazing production. Poster Fix comes to you from a real life metropolis, the metropolis known as New York City. Brooklyn is a borough of New York City. And at the time that this movie was made, New York City was considered the largest city in the world. We had the biggest buildings in the world, and the only thing you could compare the city in this movie to really was New York. Today, the world is filled with metropolises that have very tall buildings. Many cities today even outdo New York City in terms of scale and size of some of their buildings, although New York is still in the competitive run for world's tallest building. As you can see, I'm applying wheat paste both to the acid-free paper and to the poster itself. And this is going to help. This is the approach that I've chosen to use on this poster. I don't always do it the same way. If you study my other videos, you'll notice sometimes I put the wheat paste directly on the poster and other times I put it just on the acid-free paper. It depends. In this case, I thought I'd do a little bit of both. The poster is absorbing the wheat paste and expanding, and by spraying water onto the face of it, I'm helping it expand more, and I'm helping the paper to relax.
I'm going to let it absorb and expand a little bit before I stretch it out and then roll it out.
Now I'm giving the poster one last stretch out by hand before I roll it out. The poster is expanding as it absorbs wheat paste and water. Now, from the center, I'm gently rolling out the poster to get rid of the air pockets and excessive wheat paste and make sure that the poster is lying flat. Metropolis is a 1927 German expressionist science fiction drama film directed by Fritz Lang, written by Thea von Harbou in collaboration with Lang. It stars Gustav Fröhlich, Alfred Abel, Rudolf Klein-Rogge, and Bridget Helm. The silent film is regarded as a pioneering science fiction movie, being among the first feature-length movies of the science fiction genre. Filming took place over 17 months in 1925 and 26 at a cost of more than 5 million Reichsmarks. Made in Germany during the Weimar period, Metropolis is set in a futuristic urban dystopia and follows the attempts of Fredder, the wealthy son of the city master, and Maria, a saintly figure to the workers, to overcome the vast gulf separating the classes in her city and bring the workers together with John Frederson, the city master. Metropolis met a mixed reception upon release. Critics found it visually beautiful and powerful, draws influence from opera, Bauhaus, Cubist, and futurist designs, along with touches of the Gothic in the scenes in the catacombs, the cathedral, and Rotwang's house. The film's extensive running time also came in for criticism, and Metropolis was cut substantially after its first German premiere, with a large portion of Lang's original footage removed. In 1984, Italian film producer Giorgio Moroder released a truncated version with a soundtrack by rock artists including Freddie Mercury, Loverboy, and Adam Ant. This poster is for that release. In 2001, a new reconstruction of Metropolis was shown at the Berlin Film Festival. In 2008, a damaged print of Lang's original cut of the film was found in a museum in Argentina. After a long restoration process that required additional materials provided by a print from New Zealand, the film was 95% restored and shown on large screens in Berlin and Frankfurt simultaneously on the 12th of February, 2010. Metropolis is now widely regarded as one of the greatest and most influential films ever made, ranking 35th in Sight and Sound's 2012 Critics Poll. In 2001, the film was inscribed on UNESCO's Memory of the World Register, the first film thus distinguished.
And now we've got this entire screen linen backed. We've filled up the screen with Metropolis and these two World War II era posters, initiative posters.
So I'm going to put this screen out into the hallway.
Let Metropolis dry on this screen for a couple of days before we trim it down, touch it up. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
In 1984, this new restoration, which this poster depicts, and this new edit of the film, which ran 83 minutes, was made by Italian music producer Giorgio Moroder, who paid $200,000 for the rights, outbidding his Cat People collaborator David Bowie. Moroder's version, which was made in consultation with the Munich Film Archive, was tinted to emphasize the different moods and locations in the film. It also featured additional special effects, replaced intertitles of character dialogue with subtitles, and incorporated a soundtrack featuring songs Moroder composed, produced and recorded with popular artists such as Freddie Mercury, Bonnie Tyler, Pat Benatar, Adam Ant, and John Anderson. It was the first serious attempt made at restoring Metropolis to Lang's original vision, and until the restoration in 2001 and 2010, it was the most complete version of the film commercially available. The shorter runtime was due to the extensive use of subtitles instead of title cards, and a faster frame rate than the original. Moroder's version of Metropolis generally received poor reviews for not being faithful to the original. Bonnie Tyler was nominated for a Grammy Award for Best Female Rock Vocal Performance at the 27th Grammy Awards for Here She Comes.
of the Marauder version being unavailable on video in any format due to music licensing problems, it was announced that Kino International had managed to resolve the situation and the film was to be released on Blu-ray and DVD in November. In addition, the film enjoyed a limited theatrical re-release. In 2012, the Academy of Science Fiction, Fantasy, and Horror Films gave Giorgio Moroder Presents Metropolis a Saturn Award for Best DVD Blu-ray Special Edition Release. And I do want to tell you that in 1985, I saw this release at the Ziegfeld Theater in Manhattan. I remember it being quite exciting because I had already seen the film in black and white previous years, so to see it color tinted with a rock score in the 80s, because the 80s was the age of MTV and the colorization and the rock music made the movie look like one long music video. That was really what the appeal of it was back then. It just seemed like a new movie in a way, because music videos were using such odd footage in them anyway on MTV that this film in color with rock music just seemed, you know, like a great long music video, and that's what it was. That about wraps it up for today's edition of Poster Fix Studio. If you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, please send me an email, tell me the size, tell me the condition, show me a few pictures of the posters, and I'll get back to you with recommendations and a price. I look forward to seeing your posters. Thank you.